I've been a fan of New Edition since Candy Girl, which of course extended to BBD. I just remember them when I was a kid. I grew up with them. They are my generation's Temptations. So the idea that they're now turning 50 is like crazy to me, but anything that celebrates them, I'm here to celebrate.
My earliest New Edition moment was when I was a young man. We used to put on Candy Girl, and we used to dance and sing like we were the New Edition, my cousins and my brother, and we actually started a group, and I always wanted to be Ronnie. Everybody might have loved Ralph. I love you, Ralph. You know you my bro. Bobby, hey, for life, it goes deep. But it was crazy. Ronnie was always so cool. Everybody would always be like, I want to sing the lead. I'd be like, all right, cool. I'm going to be like Ron. I'm going to be cool and hold it down.
Wait. What's up? Have y'all motherfuckers saying happy birthday to this man? Did I miss that? Okay, so let's do that together one time. Wait. 50. We gotta bring the cake out. We gotta bring the cake out real quick. So let's save the cake out. Let's save the happy birthday, but yo, just give me a joint real quick, man. Stop playing. Wait.
When I was a kid at my family's house, and my aunties loved them.
I've known them since the start in Roxbury. I'm from Boston, so it's love. When they came out with Poison, because they used that Kool G Rap sample, and it was crazy.
Well, my first moment was when I was 11 years old. We had the same manager. So I really grew up around them, and I remember just in front of them, I was the biggest New Edition fan, but I had to play it off and act like, you know, I was like cool about it, but I wanted to scream all the time. So I just remember just growing up around them. They're like my big brothers, and I'm just so proud of them. The longevity that they've had in this industry is amazing, and I'm just so glad that they're getting their recognition.
And for me, I remember one of my first dates back in the day at the pier in New York. I went to see my first concert. It was New Edition and the Rapping Duke. Daha, daha. That was my first concert. I went to see them, and I was just blown away. And to fast forward, a kid from the South Bronx who's become friends with them, it blows my mind. I still, every day, no matter what in this business, I'm still a fan of people I've been a fan of.
Hands in the air, y'all. Let's rock with me one time. That's what I'm talking about. Is it okay if we slow it down just for a little while, y'all? Yeah. If you know.
Wow. 1983, when Candy Girl first blasted off. Did we think that we would be here 34 years later? On my 50th birthday, with my beautiful wife at Shamari DeVoe and our twins at the house up in the hills right now, resting, getting fed by their incredible godmother, Sarah. Did I think all of this magnificence would be going on when I was 14 years old? I can't say that I did, but at the same time, I knew I had something that was big inside of me. And that's what life is all about, knowing that you got something inside of you and then allowing it to happen and not, don't get in your own way, you know what I'm saying? This is a celebration. Big 50 Ron DeVoe.
We will. We're going to have a good time tonight. We're going to do this one for the big homies. If y'all ready out there, we're going to do it like this. Check it out one time. The heart to the home to the end.
Take a look at me. Tell me, do you like what you see? Do you think you can do me? Right here, baby. Touch me on roller. Girl, what's making you can't deal with me? Do you think you can do me?
My name is Darius McCurry.
Hey, this is Flex Alexander.
I'm Shanice.
Hello, my name is Althea Hart.
And I'm Benzino.
And you've just been buzzed.
Number one, did I? 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 Number one, did I?